The number one question I get asked by people who are just getting into sports analytics is, what language should I learn, Python or R, since they are the most used languages in the sports analytics community and industry. Today, I'm going to be diving into both the pros and cons of Python and R, and as well be giving you my consensus of which one I would choose if I were starting over from scratch. To just be straightforward, if you're here just to get a quick answer, I'm just going to say go with Python. If you're interested in why I chose Python and why I would use Python over R, then stick around as we'll be diving into those. So first, let's talk about R. If you're wondering what R is a statistical language that was developed by statisticians. When you kind of think of the people who are using R, you're not going to get your full stack developers, but rather you're going to be looking at statisticians, researchers, academics, journalists. People who are heavily focused in visualization as well are all going to be using R. And even though R is just a statistical language, it actually has a ton of benefits. And since R was developed by statisticians, they developed it with people who are using stats in mind. So this allows for a lot easier use in research, a lot easier use in academics, as well as being able to do things such as hypothesis testing, any sort of statistical modeling. R is going to allow it to be a lot easier and is a very big benefit in why a lot of people who are using R are usually in the statistical, academic, journalism fields. Second benefit of R is actually that it has very advanced visualization tools. R has a ton of packages that allow for creating great visualizations such as ggplot2, and it allows for great customability, advanced techniques, and creating more beautiful graphs overall. And in sports analytics, you probably see a lot of graphs, and so a lot of people who are creating these graphs are actually doing it a lot of time in R and creating these beautiful graphs that look really well, can be displayed on social media, in articles, on websites. In R as well, another benefit is that they have a ton of packages. Just like visualization packages, they actually have a ton of sports analytics packages. There's people who are creating packages that go and get data. There's people who are creating packages that allow you to manipulate data, create visualizations. It's plug and play. So the R community for sports analytics is great in helping you use these packages and be able to create some of your own work through these packages. So the last benefit I'm going to talk about actually is something called R Studio. So R Studio is an IDE, or basically it allows you to code and do R programming in R Studio. And the thing I like about R Studio, I'll give it to R, is that in Python, there's about a gazillion different ways to code and write code, such as Jupyter Notebooks or writing it in like an IDE, running it from the command line. In R, most people are going to be using R Studio, which makes it really easy to kind of just pick up and just start coding in R. So now jumping into kind of the negatives of R, the first big negative for me is that the syntax of R and the actual code of R is not very readable. It's not very user-friendly, and it just isn't as good as other languages might be when it comes to interpretability of the code. And as well, it's not as beginner friendly as a lot of other languages might be. It has a pretty steep learning curve, and so this can kind of push people away from learning R. And the second negative of R, and what has kind of pushed me away from it and as well as pushed a lot of other people away from it, is that it's not a general purpose language. So what this means is that it's mainly used for stats and visualization, and it's not used in like full stack software. It's not used in any like data pipelines. It's not really used outside of doing research, academics, and some visualization and journalism. So now we've talked about R, let's go into Python. Personally, I use Python every day at my job as a data engineer, whether that be from data collection, data quality, data manipulation, APIs, cloud development. I'm always working with Python. It's kind of become my go-to language for basically doing anything. Python really is the backbone of a lot of different software. In the sports analytics community, a lot of people are using Python. So let's talk about some of the benefits of Python. The first one is actually its large community and resources available to people who are programming in Python. Since Python is one of the most used languages in programming and computer science and sports analytics, there's a ton of resources, a ton of tools, and a ton of information communities out there so that you can accomplish a ton of tasks. Python community is actually great for keeping these tools and keeping these resources up to date as well, to help everybody kind of develop in Python. The second benefit of Python, and kind of one of the main reasons why I am always telling people to use Python rather than R is because Python is such an easy language to learn if you have little to no experience programming. It's very easy to read. It reads almost like English. So this can be extremely useful for people who are coming into sports analytics or coming into programming that might not have any sort of coding experience, such as like coaches or analysts that didn't have any prior experience and were never exposed to some of the concepts and techniques. So the third benefit of Python is actually a very general purpose language. It is actually used in end-to-end development, so it can be used from web scraping, collecting all this data, all the way up into like front-end APIs and stuff. So if you're using Python for sports analytics, you can use it to collect data, you can use it to build your models, and as well you can use it to serve data through APIs, serve up front-ends, dashboards, create visualizations. You're really able to create kind of this full stack development that kind of has the edge over R, where R maybe isn't able to do so well with web scraping, or it's not as well to create like a front-end. This is actually a very good benefit to Python and its ability to kind to be that general purpose end-to-end type language. The last benefit, like I mentioned before, is that it is the backbone of machine learning and AI. So if you're wanting to learn AI, data science, machine learning, data engineering, Python really is where you're going to spend most of your time. There's other languages like SQL that you're gonna need to learn as well, but Python really is that backbone of a lot of those AI machine learning tasks. So those are the benefits. Let's talk a couple negatives about Python. If you're interested in sports analytics and visualization is kind of just all you wanna do, you just wanna make visualizations, then you're probably gonna wanna go with R. Python's visualizations are not, I don't know, they're good, but they're not great. Some people may disagree with me on this, but I personally think that creating these graphics in Python requires a lot more like hacking together solutions so you can create these graphs that people in R are seamlessly making with a lot less effort. I've never really thought that Python graphs look as good as some of the R graphs that are being created, but as well, that just kind of depends on the person creating them. For me, I stink at design, so my graphs never look as good as somebody else's. Usually people in R usually creating better looking graphs. So now let's talk about what you should choose. To be honest, it's not a straightforward answer. As you can see, there are a lot of benefits, a couple negatives to each language. It really just depends on the context of what you are trying to achieve and what your personal situation is. If you are mainly just interested in visualization, doing like research, doing any sort of statistical modeling, then just go with R. But if you are more interested in AI, machine learning, data engineering, anything that has to do with full stack development, I definitely recommend Python. So that's what I'm gonna say. Learn Python just because I think you get the upper edge and you're in a better suited position to be able to do more things than just like these visualizations and research. You can build more things. So that's why I personally recommend everybody Python. It totally depends on what you want to use it for, what you want to do. So that's totally up to you. You can make the decision. So hopefully this information has helped you out and you can be able to see some of the positives and negatives of Python and R, and you can kind of make your own decision on which one is best for you. If you haven't already, be sure to subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next video.